Articulating papers are available in a wide variety of thicknesses. This is because different companies offer articulating papers in different thicknesses. And although choices are often a good thing in life, sometimes too many choices can only land up leaving us more confused. So friends, with that in mind, in this particular video, I shall be sharing with you firstly, a personalized classification with respect to the thickness of articulating papers. But more importantly, I shall share with you what is my perspective with respect to choosing different articulating papers that are available in the market. So let's start with the classification part. I personally like to cluster articulating papers into four different groups. And I'd like to call these ultra thick, thick, thin, and ultra thin. Let's look at all of these individually. Ultra thick articulating papers generally lie in the cluster of 200 microns and above. Sharing with you a couple of examples of these articulating papers that are available in the market. Now, if you were to ask me where will I use a 200 micron or thicker articulating paper, my answer is very simple. Absolutely never. In my understanding, there is no justifiable reason to using an articulating paper this thick. So ultra thick 200 plus micron articulating papers, personally, I do not use in practice at all. Let's look at the next cluster, which is thick articulating papers. Now, thick articulating papers in general, I like to cluster them as being 41 to 100 microns in thickness. Here again, a couple of examples that I am sharing with you. These are 100 micron, which is called as Progress 100 from Bausch. And then you have from Hanel and 80 micron. This is in a horseshoe form. Now, where do I prefer to use articulating papers that lie in this cluster? So in general, thick articulating papers in my practice, I prefer to use them for all forms of removable prosthodontics that I perform. These could be complete dentures, these could be cast partial dentures, these could be regular acrylic flipper kind of dentures. These require thicker papers, and that's why 100 micron or an 80 micron is generally what I prefer here. The second aspect that you see is glazed or metal prosthesis, which is where I use these thicker papers. I'm sure we all have had this clinical situation where we get either a metal crown from the lab or a glazed porcelain crown. Because of the extremely smooth surface, these don't tend to record or register articulating paper marks easily. In such situations, what I prefer to do is a two-step procedure. The first step of this is the use of a larger or a thicker paper, which is classically Progress 100, which is from Bausch. This tends to leave the surface with a large mark and leaves it slightly sticky because of the adhesive transculase that is available in that paper. Because the surface is sticky, a thinner articulating paper now begins to register marks even on extremely smooth surfaces. To help you guys understand this, I'm going to put up a link of one of the videos from my channel. This is a video courtesy Bausch. It will help you understand the two-step procedure that I use for glazed or metal prosthesis. Let's look at the next cluster, which is thin. In general, according to me, thin lies between 19 to 40 microns. Now, this is a thickness that I very commonly use in my practice. Where do I use this? Just giving you a couple of examples of these. What you see on the extreme left is from Whipmix. It's called Ardent, and that is about a 19 micron thick paper. What you see in the bottom is from Bausch. This is called RT Check, and this is 40 microns in thickness. These articulating papers, I regularly use them whenever I want to check occlusion on natural dentition. This could be directly on a tooth if I am checking for interferences, or this could be at the BISC trial phase if I were to be testing a crown or a bridge that has come back from the laboratory. It's important to understand that this is for natural teeth, because in natural teeth, a periodontal ligament is present and it allows for a certain amount of micro movement within a tooth. Now let's look at the ultra thin, which is the thinnest or the finest articulating papers that are available in the market, and I usually prefer to cluster them between 8 to 12 microns. These are extremely thin and these are usually foils and not papers, because papers in such thin dimensions would tend to tear very easily, and that's where a foil comes in. What you see in pictures on the left is a metallic foil, which is called as a shim stock. Again, I will be putting up a link of what a shim stock is and how do I prefer to use the shim stock. Also, an example of an 8 micron thick foil is Artifoil, which is available from the company Artifoil. My apologies. It's available from the company called Trollfoil. So where do I use the 8 or the 12 micron thick articulating paper? Classically, whenever I want to do implant prosthesis, like I mentioned, a natural tooth has a periodontal ligament, so I can use a slightly thicker paper. However, if I'm working on implant prosthesis that is fixed, I would most definitely want to use something that's thin, because I do not want to play with the occlusion there at all. At the same time, a 12 micron foil is used to check presence or tightness of proximal contacts between your prosthesis and the adjacent tooth. At the same time, I often use a 12 micron articulating foil also to check for friction on the intaglio surfaces of crowns. I'm sure a clinical situation that we all dentists are faced with in practice is a crown comes back from the lab, it's fitting the cast perfectly, but it's not fitting the mouth. It could be tight on the contacts, or there could be some friction on the internal or the intaglio surface, which does not allow the prosthesis to sit down to the margin. In such a situation, a 12 micron foil is what I personally prefer to use. The last point that you see, which is gauge occlusal stops, is where a shim stock is used. A shim stock is not an articulating paper because it is metallic. It's not something that transfers marks, but it definitely helps you gauge if contacts are present or not. If you wish to, I'm putting up the link of one of my videos on YouTube from my channel. You can go and watch that and then come back to this video again. So this in general, friends, is a broad understanding of what are the different papers that are available in the market and how do I personally decide what thickness to use where. At this point, when I come to a close of this session, I'd like to share with all of you all, friends, that regardless of which phase of practice do we lie in, are we a beginner in dentistry or we have an established practice, it is our moral obligation, it's our duty to make sure that patient care is at its utmost priority to us at every phase in life. With respect to articulating papers, because there are various options available in the market, what I would like to say to all of your friends is choose them wisely and make sure you use them prudently. Thank you.